Thank you very much, John Corlett. Could I just very quickly, initially, on behalf of myself and my party, again express our solidarity and sympathy with the family, community and political colleagues of Joe Cox. I think the murder of a public representative in a democracy is a very rare and shocking thing in itself. And I just, on behalf of my party...
We're having statements at the order of business.
I didn't realise that. Just
oh, sorry.
That has been communicated to me, and maybe we could work out a range of situations like this into the future. But I appreciate that, John Corlett. Taoiseach, I'm going to raise with you the issue pertaining to the anger, anxiety and great surprise at how the statutory instruments introduced by Minister Alan Kelly last January has created chaos and mayhem within the bin industry and has caused that anger and anxiety among householders across the country. There have been claims and counterclaims, but essentially bills in quite a number of instances have gone through the roof. And it highlights in many ways the complete lack of transparency in relation to bin charges generally. Quite a number of companies not transparent at all in terms of their charging regime. And the standard charges were increased under the guise of the introduction of the pay-by-weight system. Now, Minister Alan Kelly has said, and I think he signed into charges on the basis that 87% of people would have their bills reduced, but he did indicate, Taoiseach, that you and Minister Coveney and the government were caught hopping. Now, I don't know, Taoiseach, whether Minister Kelly discussed this with you last January when he signed the instrument, whether there was discussion on the Cabinet table, because I can't reconcile his view and perspective on this back then with the subsequent view that you guys were caught hopping by the companies and didn't follow through enough. Now, Minister Coveney has brought forward a range of proposals. Members of this House and spokespeople and Deputy Cowan and others asked the Minister to engage with the companies with a view to bringing about some resolution to this debacle. And essentially, we have a deferral of this charges regime for 12 months. Now, I need clarity around that, Taoiseach, from you in terms of can you guarantee that householders will not have increased bills over the next 12 months? And could you also take the opportunity over the next 12 months, Taoiseach, on the government's behalf to initiate a comprehensive review of the waste collection, management and recycling industry and system that we currently have? There's a complete absence of transparency. We have no regulator. And will you give consideration to the appointment of a regulator? There's a lack of competition in some parts of the country already. And there's illegal dumping going on at an increasing scale. So I think the next number of months, Taoiseach, should be used as an opportunity to initiate a comprehensive review of this industry and this sector. And I would ask that you would do that and you would initiate such a review.
Taoiseach.
Thank you, Deputy Martin, for his question. This has been a controversy that has blown up quite recently following the statutory instrument introduced by Minister Kelly previously. Obviously, what the government want here, I think that most deputies would agree with this, is that people would have an opportunity to think more carefully about the way that they deal with refuse and waste to be disposed of, and that by examining what should be put into a black bin, the theory and the spirit of the legislation was that less would go into that on a paperweight basis. That would mean a reduction in charges for them, and obviously better use of both a brown bin and a green bin, as the case might be. There are shortages in many cases now in capacity for landfill, so the less that goes in there, the better. Obviously, issue over the last couple of days, people were very concerned that their charges were going to rise and rise seriously. Minister Coveney did meet with the Irish Waste Management and the majority of those who supply waste services, and obviously he's announced a pay freeze with the support of the waste management companies for the next 12 months on the basis of their current pricing plans, and that means that no increase in what people have paid in respect of their last bill. And during the second half of 2016, the government and the waste industry are committed to both an intensive public awareness campaign, information and a promotion campaign, to promote the benefits of pay-by-weight charging model and to support customers in understanding how they can change their waste management behaviour and manage better their waste costs under the pay-by-weight system. I think that's in everybody's interest and it's in an environmental interest to Concorda. And no later than the 1st of January 2017, customers will receive a dual pricing bill listing the amount of waste that they are disposing of, their costs under the current pricing system, and details of what the comparative cost would be on a pay-by-weight charge. And they will be given the option to transition, if they so choose, to a pay-by-weight charging or to remain on their current pricing plan. So people have an option here and a choice to actually reduce the extent of what they put out for waste in the black bin. And after the transitional 12 months, the operation of pay by weight and the wider waste market will be reviewed to inform decisions in relation to the arrangements beyond 1st of July 2017. And also that the Minister has confirmed the commitment of the waste industry to provide a full weight allowance for the 60,000 HSE patients supplied with incontinence wear to reduce their waste charges, and the government's provision of a 50% exemption to the waste industry from the landfill levy in respect of such waste. This was a point that was made last week, and these are the changes that Minister wants to bring in. In respect of the issue that you raised, Deputy Martin, I think it's a valid thing to look at the structure and the way that the waste management of waste is actually dealt with. That is an issue that needs to be looked at, and Minister Nocton, who will be dealing with this now, will be happy to examine that from here on.
Taoiseach, did you say that the hot potato has been handed to Minister Nocton? Well, you seem to
yes,
put that in there.
Yes, it transfers across. Yeah.
That's a surprise.
No, that's already in the in
no,
the.
No, I would have thought Simon Minister Coveney was handling this proactively for the last week or two, but just you slipped in lovely there. That it's now Minister Nocton's
housing,
duty
planning, and local government, but, and obviously energy.
No, but I just make the point to Taoiseach that what I'm trying to get at is that Minister Kelly was adamant that 87% of households would be reduced. Right? Now, Minister Coveney hasn't commented on that one way or the other. The bin companies are saying that's a mathematical impossibility. You were in government with Minister Kelly at the time. Surely you discussed it. Surely you were all convinced it would bring down waste charges. What has happened has been the opposite. The bin charges have gone way up. And Minister Kelly has said you were caught hopping, Taoiseach. And I'm trying to find out, like, in between the two, how you were caught hopping. And maybe Minister Kelly could... or Deputy Kelly, no. He might illustrate that to us in greater detail. How something he introduced caught everybody hopping, it appears. It caught the companies hopping, it caught the householders hopping, and it caught his own government hopping as well. And maybe, but in a more serious vein, and I am serious on that one, but the review, Taoiseach, will you initiate a review, a comprehensive review of the industry? Because there is a lack of competition in certain places, it's a complete absence of transparency by some companies in relation to their charging. And thirdly, some companies are saying that the pay-by-weight system in itself will actually encourage cross-contamination of waste, will interfere with and undermine the recyclable material and the recyclable product that emerges from the system at the moment. So there's a lot of issues have emanated from this ill-thought-out poorly implemented statutory instrument, Taoiseach, which seems to have been used by some companies who engaged in below-cost selling to get into the market and to get a significant share to raise charges excessively and use the pay-by-weight system as a camouflage to do that.
Thank you very much. Taoiseach, you have 1 minute to respond.
I don't think that Minister Kelly set out to catch anybody in the hop, least of all the government of which he was a member. The spirit of the legislation was that by looking differently at how waste could be disposed of, the charges could be reduced. In other words, that the consumer, the customer, would have the option to examine carefully and think about how they would dispose of their waste, both in terms of green, brown and black bins, and that on a pay-by-weight basis, charges could be reduced. Now, clearly, that wasn't what was going to happen here, which is why Minister Coveney met with all of the waste management companies and has agreed with their support a freeze for 12 months with the other issues that are there. Where waste disposal companies, in a competitive sense, decided to tout for commercial business by offering a below-cost service for waste disposal. That's a matter for themselves in terms of the competitive nature of waste disposal industry. And if they decide, and if they've decided to provide a service at below cost, then that's something that they've got to live with themselves. But I would say this, in respect of the structure, you could have a situation where you could tender for an area, and the company that would win that tender would then provide the service in there. As you know, in many cases in the country, and you're quite right, there's a very different system in many places. Some roads would have 3-4 companies supplying bin collection service. And I think that's an issue. That's a valid point that you raise.
Thank you very much.
There should be an examination of the entire structure, and I think we can initiate that.
Thank you, Taoiseach. Deputy